Hey everybody, I'm Polo18 here, and today we are going to start a brand new Let's Play of The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time. Yes, I am actually recording this while NCS is at PAX Prime. He said I could do it, so that's super. Anyway, here's my practice file, which you can see I'm not very far. I'll go ahead and just erase that. Yeah. Sweetness. Alright, so let's go ahead and start a file. I will just go ahead and call myself Link for continuity's sake. Normally I would, you know, do like Empolo or some other name. But for this, we're gonna go with just Classic Link. So I wanted to do this game for a while. In the vast deep forest of Hyrule, long I have served as the guardian spirit. I am known as the Deku Tree. The Deku Tree. Oh, okay. The children of the forest, the Kokiri, live here with me. Each Kokiri has his or her own guardian fairy. Oh, that's cool. I like fairies. However, there is one boy who does not have a fairy. Aww. Poor guy. Looks like he's, like, having a sleeping seizure. And he's cold. Well, maybe you should close the window, dude. Ooh. Drawbridge is in a... some kind of eagle-y thing. And a horse. What's going on here? Oh, shit. He's having an out-of-body experience. Who's that little girl? And that lady. And oh, my God! What the... Oh my, what the, who's that guy? Look at his face. Oh, your face is too funny, Link. Navi, where art thou? Come hither. For I am William Shakespeare. That's how old the Deku Tree is, probably. Oh, Navi the Fairy, listen to my words, the words of the Deku Tree. Dost thou sense it? The climate of evil descending upon the realm. Malevolent forces are now mustering to attack our land of Hyrule. For so long, the Kokiri Forest, the source of life, has stood as a barrier deterring outsiders and maintaining the order of the world. But before this tremendous evil power, my power, says nothing. It seems the time has come for the boy without a fairy to begin his journey. The youth whose destiny is to lead Hyrule to the path of justice and truth. Navi, go now, find our young friend, and guide him to me. I do not have much time left. Fly, Navi, fly! The fate of the forest, nay, the world, depends on thee. Yes, the Deku Tree kind of has a Shakespearean feel about him, which is fine by me. Anyway, this is really cool looking how it goes into like this first-person flying mode of Navi. I always thought this was a really cool intro for a game where it, just kind of flies around as a character you never get to play as in the whole game. But it kind of gives you like an opening perspective of like, you know, what Navi sees all the time. So, oh, don't bump your head, Navi. If you die, what fairy am I going to use? I mean, the Deku Tree doesn't have many fairies, I would assume. So, I mean, don't kill yourself. Just let yourself in. Don't even close the door either, dude. No wonder you're freezing. You're eating cross-draft. You got your door open and your window open.
Hello, Link. Wake up. The Great Deku Tree wants to talk to you. Link, get up.
Yeah, I can't. I'm frozen.
Hey, come on. Can't Hyrule's destiny really depend on such a lazy boy?
Probably not. Look, I'm just... God, look at me. It's all like, fine, I was gonna sleep until like 10, but I guess I can get up.
Finally woke up! I'm Navi, the fairy. The Great Deku Tree has asked me to be your partner from now on. Nice to meet you. The Great Deku Tree has summoned you, so let's get going right now.
Right now? Like, right now? Alright, and from this point forward, Link shall never sleep again. Alright, so you kind of get like an overview of his little home here. But if you press the see up button, you can get a different viewpoint of it and kind of look around. It's actually quite cool. Just check yourself out in the mirror. Oh yeah, handsome man. Alright, so let's go ahead and get out of here. Alright, Kokiri Forest. I'm not on par with the music. I realized that after I started humming, I'm like, oh, I'm not on par. Yahoo! Hey, Link! Oh, well, I guess he's talking to me. Whoop! Oh, wait, before I talk to you, I want to check this out. Oh, too far away. Back up some. Looks like a dinosaur eating a small human. And some kind of fireball. Alright, well, anyway, let's talk to this girl.
Oh, wow, a fairy. Finally, a fairy came to you, Link. Wow, what great news. I'm so happy for you. Now, you're a true Kokiri. Is that right? The Great Deku Tree has summoned you? It's quite an honor to talk to the Great Deku Tree. I'll wait for you here. Get going. Go to see the Great Deku Tree.
Alright, so indeed we will go see the Great Deku Tree, but, there's this asshat over here. Oh, hey, a sign. Let's check the sign. Check the sign.
Hey!
Just ahead. Great Deku Tree's meadow. Oh, cool. He's even got a meadow. Alright, so you can kind of see, like, up at the top, there's that little flashing thing that says Navi. Go ahead and click on it. It says,
the Great Deku Tree has summoned you. Please, come with me.
Yeah, every now and then she'll do that. Like, if you get lost on where you're supposed to go. So, anyway, there's this guy standing here. Let's... Get out of the way! Get out of the way! Ah, fine.
Hey, you! Mr. No Fairy, what's your business with the Great Deku Tree? Without a fairy, you're not even a real man. What? You got a fairy? Say what? The Great Deku Tree actually summoned you? What? Why would he summon you and not the Great Mido? This isn't funny. I don't believe it. You aren't even fully equipped yet. How do you think you're going to help the Great Deku Tree without both a sword and a shield? Ready? What? You're right. I don't have my equipment ready, but... If you want to pass through here, you should at least get equip a sword and a shield. Sheesh.
So we need a sword and a... Oh, fuck. We don't have a sword or a shield. Alright, so let's, we can climb on top of this house. Yeah, let's go up here. I like how like the camera turns here. There's another area later in the game that does that too. Oh no, there we go. Yeah, there's another area in the Hyrule Overfield that does that. It changes the camera as you run. So anyway, so one cool thing about Kokiris is like you look back here, all you see is a fairy, right? Closer you get. Oh, there she is.
Oh, hee! You came all the way up here. You're a real man. Look, isn't this view pretty? Change your viewpoint with see up, so you can look around the forest with the control stick.
That's pretty much what I just did. So anyway, click see up, and then you can move the control stick around. If you left and right, the control stick won't like auto return. Like now I'm looking up and it's auto returning, or I'm looking down and it's auto returning. You go left or right, that doesn't do it because you're actually turning Link's body. So, like, if you want to get centered on something, like, I want to get centered on this platform, you just go ahead and run. And then if you want to go ahead and do it again, you can go ahead and get, like, kind of centered. And if you hold Z, you can strafe. Which is like this. You can strafe back and forth. So yeah, it's actually kind of cool. So yeah, so we went and picked up 5 rupees. We're gonna need rupees because later we're gonna go to the shop and we're gonna need to buy our shield. Is this Mido's house, I think? Yeah, okay. I never really ever got rupees from here. I watched an LP of this and saw that you could come in here and get rupees from Mido's house. But I never ever came in here. Because I thought, yeah, you know, it's just a useless house. But you can actually get, what is this, 12 rupees? 11 rupees. You can get 11 rupees from Mido's house. So, and that'll help. seeing as we only need 40 to get to the enough for the shield. So, also you can run around in grass, and that'll get you some rupees. There's some more grass over here. Let's go ahead and run in this. Yeah, rupees. All right. Let's see. Another thing you can do. You can jump across these, and you get 5 rupees. So that's really cool. All right. I don't think you can do it both ways. Nope. All right. But where we're gonna want to go is we're gonna want to go get our sword, and you could walk around and talk to people. But check this sign. Check. There we go. Forest Training Center. Don't recklessly cut signs. Read them carefully. All right. So let's go ahead and go through here. What does this say? Hole of Z. Let's go through this small hole. Stand in front of the hole and push forwards on the control stick. When the icon says enter, press A to crawl in the hole. Alright, so let's, there we go. Sweet! Alright, so let's go ahead and crawl through here. So. Alright, so we're here now. Let's check this sign. Viewpoint with Z targeting. When you have no object to look around, you can look forward with Z. Stop moving and then change the direction you're facing or hold down Z for a little while. Yep. So pretty much that's the whole looking forward. Oh shit, a boulder. Oh shit, it's chasing me. Ah, fuck. Did that hurt me? Yeah, it did. I just can't see the top of the screen from the... Okay, seriously? Get off me! Get off me, dude! I hate you, fucking boulder. I thought if I cut through that little, like, grassy path, it wouldn't come get me, but apparently it does. Alright, so this is the first and ever treasure chest that's big you'll find in the game. And it's got the Kokiri sword. In the equipment subscreen, select it with the cursor and equip it with A. This is a hidden treasure of the Kokiri, but you can borrow it for a while. Be sure to practice with it before you really fight. Alright, so we don't have any sword, as you can see. So let's go ahead and open our start menu, and here we have our map, our quest status, our equipment, and our select items. So let's go ahead and equip the Kokiri sword, and we also have our Kokiri tunic and boots. Pretty much it's just the normal boots. Let's see if I can get over here before that thing happens. Anyway, so we got our sword now. If you have your sword out, you'll run with it out. You can also roll with it. If you stand still and wait, you can sheathe it, which is kind of cool. You can cut grass with it. If you hold down your B button, your sword button, you can do a spin attack. And I think, see if I can do this right. I'm gonna wait for this boulder. But I think if you, come on. Do it! Okay, it's a safe area. Do it! Okay, it's not gonna do it. Anyway, if you rotate the control stick around either clockwise or counterclockwise once and press B, you can do a quick spin, which I obviously can't do. So yeah, anyway, there's a rock here. Let's go ahead and read the sign. Check. Switch targeting. If you see an arrow icon above an object, you can target it with Z. In other words, if you press Z when the arrow icon is above an object, you can lock onto it. If you press Z again, the lock will either release or it will transfer to the next object with the arrow above it. Okay. So yeah, so like you can see here, like I'm targeting this. If I press Z again, it'll change. But I actually have it on hold targeting, so like right now I'm holding Z, but if I let go, it'll untarget. And pretty much what that'll do is the whole targeting thing, where it'll switch, like here. There we go. Talk to this guy. Hey, let's work on some moves. To jump sideways while Z targeting, press A while you move right or left. To do a backflip while Z-tarting, which I actually just did on accident, press A as you move backwards. To do a roll attack while Z-targeting, press A as you move forward. While you roll, you can avoid damage. If you have your sword ready while Z-targeting, you can do a jump attack by pressing A. Jump attack does double damage. You can use Z-targeting on the stone next to me, so let's practice. Alright, so I already did the backflip, which was this. You can also jump and roll. Sometimes I was trying to jump from side to side, but it changes the camera. If you have your sword out, you can jump backwards, and there you go. You can do a jump attack. And I can't take this boulder? Okay, well, that's fine. Alright. So you can also... Well, I can't grab that. You can also cut these big bushes and cut signs. So your heart's contained. Let's grab that cookie. Alright, so now we are going to want to go over to the shop. Just go this way. Ah, yeah, let's speak to her.
Oh, you have a fairy now? That's great, Link. What? You've been called by the great Dekutri. What an honor. He may give you a special gift. Tee-hee. That's because the great Dekutri is our father, the forest guardian, and he gave life to all of us Kokairi.
Nice. Alright. So let's go ahead, and this big red hut thing is the shop. So this chick will stop you.
Hey, Link! Look this way! Look over here with C! Talk to me! With A!
Alright.
Yes, yes, that's how you use a fairy!
Oh, she's just gonna explain... You know, she pretty much is explaining the same thing. Pretty much what Navi will do is, she'll, like, hover out to close targets that you can Z to. There's this guy who's, like, trying to hop over the counter.
Welcome!
Alright, so there's some stuff in here we can get. We can't buy arrows yet, because we don't have anything to shoot them with. We can't buy Deku seeds, because we don't have anything to shoot them with. You can get a recovery heart for 10 rupees. There's Deku nuts. They kind of work like flashbangs. Deku sticks, long branch gathered at the Deku tree. You can use it as a weapon. But we're going to get the Deku shield, since that's what we need to get to the Deku shield. You got a Deku shield. Switch to equipment and select the shield. Press A to equip it. Press R to crouch and defend. If you press R while Z-targeting, you can move while defending. Would you like to buy anything else? No, thank you. Let's GTFO. Alright, so let's go ahead and equip our shield. Nice. Alright, so let's see if I can... Okay, so this is just R shielding. Let me... Oh, hold on. There we go. So you can see he points up and left and right. If you're Z-targeting while shielding, you'll actually stand, which you can't change the camera angle on here, which is kind of a bummer. If you're targeting while you're shielding like this without a Z, you can do a crouch stab. If you're standing while doing this, you can do a regular stab. If you're Z-targeting, you do a down stab, side stab. If you shield and target, you can't attack at the same time. You either have to let go of R to attack, or let go of Z, and that'll get you out, and then you can crouch stab. So let's go ahead and put our stuff away, since we don't need it. Oh, I got 5 more rupees, nice. Alright, what are we up to? Oh boy, 18 minutes, okay. Oh wait, that's the way to go out. I'm going the wrong way. Alright, so that's pretty much all the, like, really beginning stuff that I wanted to cover. So, let's go ahead and... Let's cover Mido's sprite. There we go. And next time, let's play The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. Now that we have a sword and a shield, we're going to talk to Mido. Fucker.